Yes!
I was surprised at how quick I went through this dungeon. I was expecting, you know, 20, 30 necromancers in here just kicking my ass.
Let's return to Anesia in the Elder Gleam Sanctuary. I
find this a bit scary. So, where are we going now?
We were missing somebody. Yeah, Aella wasn't with us. Okay, let's try this again. Okay. My hard drive's filling up. I don't know if I can even record what I'm trying to do here. Okay, so looks like everyone's here. I brought an overkill with me. I mean, I think I could have just done this. I'm so used to necromancers being totally overpowered in my game. I just need to remind myself that I don't have those mods installed. All I have is for combat would be Imperius and Wildcat. I think that's it. Staggered in a tunnel by the rock dude. Rock dude making a blizzard storm of some kind. A rock storm? I guess it's like Sharknado, but it's rocks instead of sharks. Something like that. You guys coming? That thing was blocking traffic, I guess. I can read whose was that one anyway? I guess it helps to come in here when they're all asleep. Maybe I'm guessing I haven't done that before, or are they always maybe they're always asleep. Doesn't matter what time of day. Just like with most bandits, they're probably always sleeping. There used to be like a bunch of cultists sitting here doing stuff, but I guess I don't have that mod.
Do you have it?
I just got it.
At last, the final totem is ours. Let's go complete our set.
Well, so for a change, I'm actually in a dungeon that Aella needs me to go to. I was borrowing her. taking her all over Skyrim.
Huh? Yes! Sir!
The spirit of Skior.
There were four of us in there? There were five of us? Really? I had including myself, there's five people in that cave. No, I don't feel like going off a cliff. I'll go down the trail because I want my followers to follow me. I don't want them to get stuck on a rock. So today I was on the Nexus and I saw a mod. It's got two followers. They're both werewolves. They turn into werewolves. And I thought, oh cool, I'm going to download them. My instant a knee-jerk reaction would be to download the mods. Download them. Because I like having followers, theoretically, hypothetically, that can turn into werewolves. But before I hit the download button on that thing, I read the description, and the author says they're using the code that Rust uses. Well, the code that Rust uses is broke as far as I'm concerned. So
people these days.
I'm not gonna download that mod. Cause then you end up with you'll end up with
shall we go inside?
The NPC and the werewolf they turn into, both of them following you around. Times two, that's the kind of nonsense that mod's gonna do for people. You'll have the two followers and then their two werewolves. Because they didn't join back together again during the transformation. Uh-oh. Abort landing. I wonder where he came from. He must have come from way over yonder, where a Dawnguard is. I'm not gonna worry about it.
Yes, sir.
Come on!
This is weird. I got some new neighbors recently. They moved in about a month and a half ago. And ever since they moved in, they're potheads. They're alcoholics and they're potheads. It's weird, they smoke their marijuana and they drink their booze and they go driving off somewhere. Anyway, they hang out with my other neighbors. And so now I see my other neighbors that have been living here for a couple years. They're drinking the booze and the smoking the pot. And getting in a car and driving off somewhere. They just... I swear that... too much government's getting in the way of what people can and can't do. You know, the cops are gonna... they're told to arrest anyone who does that. And then the other cops... or the federal side are saying, nope, it's legal, they can do it in the states law. But what do we have cops for then? You know, what's happening in the retail stores where people aren't allowed to go after thieves? Totally not used to controlling a werewolf. I'm out of practice. So if a store manager tries to apprehend a shoplifter, guess what happens to the store manager? He gets fired. You know, if a bus driver driving a bunch of school kids somewhere decides to pull over and stop one of the kids from raping another kid, guess what happens? He gets fired. Now that trickles up to what cops are allowed to do. And we're seeing it now, aren't we? In the United States, cops can't be arresting people. You see more and more cops just sitting in their cars, not getting out to help. Because they're told by the higher-ups, don't arrest people. Anyway, so the criminal element that's in some people's minds, you know, they see this going on. You know, the criminal mind knows right away what cops can and can't do. And when they see the governor telling everybody, hey, no more do cops do this kind of stuff, then that's like you're giving the signal. You know, stuff that used to be crazy illegal to do is now just everyday behavior now. It was like 20 years ago, maybe even 30 years ago. You had these families wanting to homeschool their kids because the public school systems were beginning to suck. now, those same kind of families, they're looking to just get out of the town. You know, it's hard enough trying to homeschool a kid. So they want to get out of Dodge and go live in a cabin in a mountain somewhere. Away from people. You know, try to start over civilization out on the frontier somewhere. Because in the cities, civilization in the cities, it's failed. It's a complete failure. You know, cities, you know, basically cities have rules of laws, and if they're not followed, then what happens to the city? Oh, I think I'm changing back. Oh. Can I get to the top of this hill at least? Before I switch? Oh. Butt naked. So what's the deal here now? I'm using better males. I went back to using better males. I wish there was a way to turn off that female self-cover animation if you're not a female. You would think the script would just check, are you a dude or not a dude? If you're not a dude, do the animation. If you are a dude, don't do the animation. But whoever wrote the mod just assumed that no one ever plays male characters in the game. It's weird, there. I don't know if I should say this, but I'm gonna say it anyway. There are weirdos who play both male characters and women characters. Because I hear all the time, you know, some guy, in his videos, he only plays the female character.
I used to own quite a good bow. Did I ever tell you that? So, where are we going now?
Oh, I thought she was gonna tell me about it. She's teasing me. Oh, I forgot she does that. She's planting a seed in my head about a bow. Sure enough, a week from now, she's probably gonna say, "Can I tell you something about my bow?"
Anyway, yes?
I can't read what I just typed there.
Sure.
What did I type there from like a week ago?
As you wish. Sure. All right.
Maybe I said something like, did I sell her bow to somebody?
Sure. Sure.
Because I think I found it.
Shall we continue?
But didn't give it to her, and I ended up selling it. That could have happened. It's not a quest item. You can totally get rid of stuff that you find for her. When I say quest item, I mean items that you can't just give away by accident. But yeah, so people will say, you know, guys that play Skyrim and they only role play, you know, the female character or whatever. They only make female characters to play in the game. They'll say that's weird if a guy only plays female characters. I don't know if that's weird or not. And then same for, guys that only play male characters in Skyrim. I don't know if that's weird either. But what I do think is weird are guys that play female or male characters. Doesn't matter. But while they're playing the game, they're dressed up as a girl. They're wearing women's clothing. They've got makeup on. They're wearing... They have their hair done like a girl does her hair. To me, that's weird. There's guys on YouTube that do that while they're playing. They're Skyrim. And they have the camera on them. Just to let the audience know that's the kind of person they are. Like a virtue signal of some kind. Used to be, in the old days, they used to call it a cry for help. Now it's just called virtue signaling. Because after a while, when you have too many people doing their little cry for help, after a while, it loses its meaning, its relevance. It just becomes a weird subculture of some kind. Eventually, a subculture becomes a culture.
If I can just stand up.
Nothing to see here, Rigmor. Okay. Yeah, I still can't change Rissa's clothes yet because she has no respect for my character whatsoever. So that outfit's bolted onto her.
I don't know.
Who is that? Was that Dirkethus?
This is not the time for talk. Let's get to the Underforge and see what this can do.
Greetings, honored friend.
Okay, my hard drive is just grinding away. I'm like down to like 4 megabytes. Or is it 4 gigabytes? I don't remember. I think my plan was to go... I need to go back to that cave. But I also want to go to Windhelm so I can take a carriage ride back to Whiterun. At least that's the plan, I guess. Oh yeah, so I'm using better males because I got tired of looking at my nasty toes that I had before. Before my toes were just painted on a stub. They call a foot in the original game.
What a nice place. Oh, I'd love to see you for a while. The moat looks really warm. What say you?
We just got here. Already we're causing a scene.
Don't hurt me. You win.
Is that Rigmor doing something with the natives? Meanwhile, Where's that cave? There it is.
There's a cave. There may be treasure hidden inside.
Got one here. Oh, everyone's here. Counting heads.